Everybody can be seated. On behalf of Jeremy and Suzanne and all their family and friends, I want to welcome you here today because this is a special, special moment. This is a time of celebration. This is a time of remembrance. And as Jeremy has reminded me a lot over the past 24 hours, Jesus first. This is a time to remember the redeeming work of Jesus and the bringing together of two lives being made into one. It's really an honor today. So everybody, welcome. We're so glad you're here to join in this special moment as we lift up the name of Jesus and celebrate what God is doing in bringing together Jeremy and Suzanne. One of my biggest pieces of marriage advice, and this is important, I want you guys to look at me for just a moment. This is really, I know you're infatuated with each other, it's great. All right. Marriage is awesome. It's just awesome. Marriage is an incredible gift from God to us. It's God's design, and you're in for a lifelong journey of getting to know what it means to be husband and wife. Now, when you look at Suzanne, Jeremy, do you love her? Suzanne, when you look at Jeremy, do you love him? That's a good start. Proud of you guys. Now, as you are overflowing with love, this is just the beginning of your marriage together. As you're married for 5, 10, 15, 20 years, and God willing, as your marriage continues to grow until the day you die, you're going to be on a journey of loving each other and getting to know each other and what it means to journey together as one. This is a special day, so always remember that marriage is awesome and enjoy it. There's a verse that I know is really special to Jeremy's heart and when I think about you guys, and I know that everybody on this stage and so many here today would concur, Psalm 42, the first couple verses, scripture says, "As a deer pants for flowing streams, so pants my soul for you, O God. My soul thirsts for God, the living God." This is something, both of you as worshipers of Jesus, it's in you. Your hunger and your thirst for Jesus Christ. And it's a beautiful thing to see God bring together two people who love him so much and who are overjoyed and overflow with worship to Jesus. You know, God gave marriage as a picture of what it's like of Jesus Christ and his church. And Paul talks about this in the book of Ephesians. It's a beautiful picture. Jeremy, as you love Suzanne and lay down your life for her, as the world watches how you treat her, how you spoil her, how you love her, they're seeing a glimpse of what Jesus Christ did for his church. They're seeing a picture of how Jesus Christ laid down his life for his people. Every time you sacrificially love Suzanne, it's a testimony to the world about what Jesus has done for his people. And Suzanne, as you love and honor Jeremy and adore him and lavish your love on him, you're showing the world a glimpse of how the church just responds to Jesus Christ for his sacrificial love. You two coming together on this journey is showing the love of Jesus and what he's done for his people and how his people respond to him. It really is a Jesus first moment. It's a time where we see two lives coming together and we remember that Jesus Christ loves his people so much, that he laid down his life. Because one day, we're going to be united with him as his bridegroom. One of my favorite verses in all of Scripture is from Colossians 3, verses 12. Now, I know, Jeremy, you're a worshiper, Suzanne, you're a musician, and I think Jeremy plays a little bit too. So there's one of my favorite words in this scripture, and is that news to you? Is that surprising? Okay, just double checking. Colossians 3, 12 to 15. I have a feeling you're still going to be finding out things about each other, you know, in the coming months. Colossians 3, starting at verse 12. "Since God chose you to be the holy people he loves, you must clothe yourselves with tender-hearted mercy, kindness, humility, gentleness, and patience. Make allowance for each other's faults and forgive anyone who offends you. Remember, the Lord forgave you, so you must forgive others. Above all, clothe yourselves with love, which binds us all together in perfect harmony. Now, I love that word harmony. I love that word harmony. Harmony is when two things just sound right together. They work together. It's like, yeah, that's how it should be. You guys, as you come together today, you're not only in harmony with each other, you're in harmony with Jesus. The way it's supposed to be. The way it should be. Without him, you can't have harmony. With him, you guys are coming together, and everywhere you go, you're injecting the love of God. Every step you take. When I've been praying about you guys and asking the Lord just for some words over you, the thing that I feel the Lord keeps saying is that as you guys have poured yourself into others in making disciples and raising up sons and daughters, you're doing that now as a team. Your house is a disciple-making ground. You guys are going to be raising up powerful people. You're going to be highly involved in their healing and restoration and release into ministry. You've done this individually. Now there's going to be this time where you do it together as a team. And it's going to be more powerful. The anointing is going to flow, and you are going to have spiritual sons and daughters who you equip and you send out in ministry all over. This is a special, special moment for you guys. Today, I encourage you to press in to how much Jesus loves you. Don't be afraid to allow his love to take you to those who need it. And your love for each other will be a testimony to the world of how Jesus Christ loves his church. John 15:12, this is my commandment, love each other in the same way I have loved you. Jesus first. Lord, I thank you for these two people, for Jeremy and Suzanne, who are sold out lovers of you. Thank you for two lives that you're bringing together today. And as they get ready in the next few moments to say their vows and exchange their rings, we pray just a blessing over them, that everything you have in store for them, they would walk in. Every good thing that you've prepared in advance for them to do, that they would walk in together, hand in hand, as a team, and as two lives made one. Amen. Suzanne. In the company of witnesses, Jeremy and Suzanne are going to exchange their vows of love and dedication and affection for each other. Jeremy, I'll start with you. You can repeat after me. I, Jeremy, take you, Suzanne.
I, Jeremy, take you, Suzanne.
To be my beloved wife.
To be my beloved wife.
To have and to hold you.
To have and to hold you.
To honor you.
To honor you.
To treasure you.
To treasure you.
To be at your side.
To be at your side.
In sorrow and in joy.
In sorrow and in joy.
In the good times,
in the good times,
and in the bad,
and in the bad,
and to love and cherish you always,
and to love and cherish you always.
I promise you this from my heart, for all the days of my life,
for all the days of my life.
Suzanne, I, Suzanne,
take you, Jeremy,
to be my beloved husband,
to have and to hold you.
To honor you,
to treasure you,
to be at your side,
in sorrow and in joy,
in the good times,
and in the bad,
and to love and cherish you always.
I promise you this,
from my heart,
for all the days of my life.
Rings are a beautiful sign and a remembrance of the endless love of God for you, and as a testimony to the world. So, Lord, I pray that you'd bless these rings, that they would be a sign of the vows by which Jeremy and Suzanne have bound themselves to each other through Jesus Christ. Amen. Jeremy. I give you this ring.
As a symbol
of my love and faithfulness.
I give you this ring.
As a symbol
of my love and faithfulness.
Jeremy and Suzanne, the two candles that were lighted at the beginning of the service by our mothers, they symbolize your separate lives, your separate families, and your separate sets of friends that are about to come together. We pray now that at the joining of these candles into one, that it would be a sign of what God is doing in your hearts and in your lives. During the lighting of the Unity candle, I want to encourage everybody here just to spend a few moments, either quietly or around your table, just praying for these guys. This is a power couple. Do you know that? Power of the Holy Spirit is so strong in these guys. So we want to pray and bless what God is doing. We want to cover them with intercession, and we want to see them accomplish everything that the Lord has for them. So this is a great time, as the candles are being lit, for you guys to intercede for them. So we're going to take a few moments to do that. And the dads can come up and bring the fire for the guys.
The wine and the bread and the sons of
like to pray and bless you guys. I pray, may the love of God be above you to overshadow you, beneath you to uphold you, before you to guide you, behind you to protect you, and within you to empower you. Now that Jeremy and Suzanne have given themselves to each other by vows, with the joining of hands and the giving and receiving of a ring, I pronounce that they are husband and wife in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Those whom God has joined together, let no one separate. Jeremy? You may now kiss your bride. For this day. We thank you for this moment. We thank you that we can celebrate together as family and friends, Jeremy and Suzanne coming together. It is now my privilege to introduce to you for the very first time, Mr. and Mrs. Jeremy Foster.
Can't say I didn't notice it was absent, 'cause I could live by the light in your eyes. Unfold before you what I've strung together, the very first words of a
we'll be right back.
this is love. Mm-hmm. So this is love. So this is what makes life. I'm all aglow, and now I know,
and now I know
the key to all is mine. My heart has wings beneath, and I can fly.